Hey friends, Mike here. It's May 18th, Wednesday, and it's hot. We've lost a lot of plants, especially in our hugelkultur garden. That's okay. We've got more time. It's just, it shouldn't be 100 degrees this early in the season. We're just having a heat spell. Today's Wednesday, it's gonna be 100. Tomorrow, Thursday, 101, 101. And then we're supposed to get a cool front in Friday, but still Friday it's gonna be 100. You know, this early in the year, this is the chance to where, you know, we're normally in the upper 80s, maybe 90, and that would give our plants time, you know, to get established. So I've replanted some seeds and we've done some extreme shade cover. So let me show you what we got going on. The little shade cover over here, the tomatoes, they're doing fine, but I just want to make sure. Now, these are our San Marzano Roma tomatoes. I definitely want to make sure that we produce so we can make tomato sauce. So here is the 40% shade cover I just put up real quick over the hugelkultur garden. Had to clean a lot of the old growth out. We lost a lot. We still have some squash growing, but I'm thinking this 40% shade cover is definitely gonna help. With any new seeds that come out. We've got time. It's early in the season. As you can see, we lost a bunch. The grow table's doing good. The goji berries are making it. So I'm excited about that. And I've got some of them also too, still in water. And they're producing roots more so than they were. Grow tables are doing fine. The potatoes, we even got tomatoes. So I'm happy about that. You know, you lose some, you win some, you just keep replanting. And you know, the thing about here in Central Texas is that you can just keep planting all year, really. You've got it, we've got all, two seasons. So everything else looks doing great. We've got tons of peppers. We're gonna be harvesting peppers, a lot of banana peppers. Turnips are coming up nice. Just had to thin them out a little bit. So yeah. Garden is doing pretty good. I'll check in the next couple of days. This squash patty pan, I don't think it's gonna make it. Now you can only water so much. The soil is nice and moist, but you know, when you have intense heat, no rain, Texas is 80% in drought. And from here where we are west, oh, heck, all the way up into New Mexico, it's severe drought. So we'll make it the best we can and just keep planting. And there is a front that's coming in Friday, hopefully for some rain and normal temperatures for next week, the next couple of weeks, upper 80s. And maybe in the mornings in the upper 60s, which would be wonderful. We'll check back in here in the next couple of days. Hey guys, well, it's Thursday, May 19th. Rochelle and I are doing our normal watering. Hey, let's check this out. It's, what time is it? 7:51. Hey, computer and the phone, what's the temperature outside?
It's about 88 degrees outside.
Wow, it went down. It was 98 today. Just an odd time of the year. We're gonna get a cool front. This Sunday, we got two more days of upper 90s, and it's been, I'll be honest with you, it's been a struggle. I've been gardening in this climate for 30 years, both Rochelle and I, and it's tough. We've lost squash plants, we've had to replant seeds, but I'll just kind of give you a quick look around so you can kind of get an update, and then we'll be harvesting tomorrow morning, and I'll film then, and we'll just post this Friday, just kind of a 2 or 3 day update. So let's check it out. Tomatoes are doing good. I've done a lot of pruning, but we've got a lot of burnt ends. And you know what? You can mulch and you can water to every day, twice a day. But look, when the sun, this early in the year, when the plants are coming up 99 degrees to 100 degrees, it's gonna happen. But we're gonna make it through it. You can see this tomato plant is kind of hurting too. We're gonna prune it. Hey, next week, it's gonna be highs in the mid to lower 80s. All the beans across the fence, the perennial garden, hey, it's suffering. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna wait and I'm gonna actually go buy plants and just put them in. Most of the garlic is harvested. We've got some more in here. Butter beans are doing good. Again, tomatoes are just kind of hanging in there. Pruning. Probably do some more pruning tomorrow. Hey, look, there's nothing better than natural rain. So let's check out the peppers. I'm really happy about the peppers. So we've got lots of little small Hungarian hot wax peppers. Now, obviously, when we harvest these little bad boys, they're gonna get bigger. These beautiful hot banana peppers are looking really good. Tomorrow morning, I'm gonna harvest those. Now, we've got some sriracha peppers. These are kinda, some of them are kinda hurting, but you know, we'll harvest them and I'll probably just backpack them and freeze them till I have enough to where I can make a sriracha sauce. Jalapenos are doing really good. We'll harvest these in the morning. We'll put some more blood meal on the plant. Some natural chicken fertilizer. We're feeding, foliar feeding with Medina Has to Grow, which basically I showed y'all in the last video. It has seaweed, which I couldn't find. So you gotta watch out for the shortages. But Medina has it. Anytime I see seaweed, liquid seaweed, I'm gonna get it. Horticultural molasses and fish fertilizer. So foliar feeding in the evening. The seaweed has a compound in it that's gonna go ahead and help toughen the plant, whether it be extreme cold or extreme hot. Romanian cucumbers are doing good. We're doing a series video on that. Leeks are just amazing. Lots of shade cover. Oh goodness. Unfortunately, we lost a lot of the squash in the Hugo culture garden. The squash borer bugs. I wasn't diligent enough with diatomaceous earth, but we replanted seeds. Everything in here will come up again next week. It's going to be a normal Texas May weather, 80s. We harvested some more garlic. We've got them drying up in here, so we're excited about that. But no, things are going okay. We're going to make it. We just got to get through the next 2-3 days. Our air condition was down for 2 days. Oh God. Whew, can you imagine that? But we got that up and running and we made it through that time. So I'll check back in with you guys tomorrow morning. We'll harvest some of those peppers. I gotta just wonder how people lived in the 1800s here in the South with no AC. I don't know. We'll see you tomorrow. Have a good night. Hey friends, it is Friday the 20th. Thank God it's Friday. We're gonna go ahead and start harvesting some of these peppers. I'm excited about that. We've got some of these small, little tiny first harvest banana peppers. I'm gonna do a quick pickle with those. So yeah, let me get you in closer here and we'll just pick some peppers. Yeah, these first picks are small, but I'll tell you what, they're gonna be really good for a quick pickle, like a peppercini style. Now remember, the more you harvest, the more you're gonna get. Now I'm not gonna pick all these. Some of them I'll like get a little bigger. Now guys, we really, this whole month it's been mid to upper 90s and that's not normal for here. Yeah, it's Texas, it gets hot, but it should be upper 80s, maybe mid 80s. Now we're getting a front that's coming in this weekend, and it is going to cool down a lot, and we're going to get some rain, which is, we're in a deficit. 80% of Texas is in a drought. 50% from central to west is in a severe drought, so we need that rain, but it's coming. Well, that old branch fell off. That's okay. You know, every year is different. You kind of learn as you go. Been gardening for, gosh, 30 years since I got out of the Army. Gardened too when I was a young man with our parents. We grew up eating out of the garden. I remember mom and dad saying, hey guys, go out and get some peppers and maybe harvest a little bit of this and that, some herbs. And my mom, she made dinner. So we haven't done any fertilizing here because of the weather's been so hot. Here, probably the rain is gonna start here in a few couple days. I'm gonna come out with an organic fertilizer. And I'm also gonna put out some blood meal. And we're doing the foliar feeding as well too. And again, we're using the Medina product that has to grow. It's got seaweed, fish emulsion, horticultural molasses. So I think I'm gonna leave this one as is. We got a couple more here. And that's enough for a little half pint, some quick pickles. Throw them in the fridge, we'll use them. Yeah, that'll be fine for now. And we'll harvest some of these other bananas. These are a sweet variety, so they tend to get a little bigger. These ones came out really nice. Good right there. Same with these, I'll probably just go ahead and slice them and do a nice little quick pickle. Looking good. All right, let's go check and see if we have jalapenos. These right here are a sriracha. Just kind of found them randomly this year. Just had a difficult time starting seeds. You know, I don't always buy or start my plants with seeds. Just with plants like this, I just go ahead and buy them. I can afford it. But I do start seeds. This is a cayenne. These are gonna turn red. And of course, we've got our jalapenos. Now, we've got jalapenos. We've got peppers growing all over in pots as well, too. That looks good. Yeah, these are looking really good. All right. I'm happy about that. They're gonna start, once the rain comes, they're gonna start really producing, and then we're gonna fertilize. We've got our poblanos. We've got another variety of poblano. Cherry tomatoes are looking good. Of course, everything is struggling. Not good. Guys, it's been 99 degrees for 20 days in a row. It's been very difficult. See, you can even see the foliage burning. You know, you can water all you want. This is still gonna happen. You know, it's gonna get better. The weather is gonna be better. I'm gonna keep filming here through the weekend. And we'll kind of show you guys what's going on with the weather. And I'll probably post this probably Sunday so you can kind of see the change from being 99 to 80 with rain. So, Rochelle has a really cool craft that she's gonna show y'all here Saturday. I'm gonna film that. So stay tuned for that. That's gonna be really exciting. It's kind of a two-part system thing where you can use an item to water your potted plants and you can make labels. So we'll see you then. That's going to be exciting. Nice little first harvest. There'll be plenty more here in a couple of weeks. All right, so I brought you in the kitchen because we're going to do a little quick pickling. Hey, it's one of the easiest little things you can do to preserve your food. You don't have to can or boil it or nothing. It's just a quick pickle, so let me run you through it. All right, first thing is sanitation, sanitation, sanitation. As a chef, I can't say that enough. I've already put these jars in the dishwasher and I steamed them. I use a product called One Step, okay? It's a sanitizer, it's a powder. You mix it with water, and it's a no rinse. So I sanitized everything. Everything I'm gonna use that's gonna touch the product, the lids, the funnel, everything. And that just sits. You don't have to rinse it. I'm gonna come back here. And we'll get set up, but let me show you the ingredients. So for a quick pickle, the brine is really easy. It's simple. It's one part water to one part vinegar. Now for this, I'm gonna use white vinegar. I like that nice crisp spice on my peppers. You could use apple cider, you can use rice wine vinegar. Heck, I even have champagne vinegar. So equal parts. I'll go ahead and measure. I don't usually measure, but we'll go ahead and do 1 cup of vinegar. You know, I'll just double this. We'll just do 3/4 to 3/4. If I have any left over, I can always refrigerate. Super easy. And there we go. Now I'm gonna go ahead and throw in 1 tablespoon of canning salt. And you can adjust this to your taste. And 1 tablespoon, this is a measuring tablespoon of sugar. Sometimes I'll put a little more sugar in there just to kind of balance that. Super easy. I'll put a little trio of peppercorns. It's the multicolored ones. Dill seed, gotta have it. Just what I like. And celery seed. Remember, the sky's the limit. You can flavor your pickles anything you want. I mean, these are peppers. I want the peppers to stand out, but a little bit of flavor is nice. Sometimes I'll even throw in some garlic. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Just gonna put a couple of cloves of garlic in. I'm not gonna chop it up. I'm just gonna use that to flavor the brine. And then I'll pull it out because it will turn blue in some cases. And onto the stove. We'll get this fired up. I always guess the wrong burner. Silly me. Okay guys, I'm gonna go ahead and strain the brine. I just like my brine to be really clear. Everyone should have one of these. Sometimes people will call this a China cap, but it is called a chinois. I'll go ahead and put some information down in the bottom, but it's a really ultra fine filter. And I might do it the second time as well too, back into the other container. Okay, now I'm gonna take it a step further and I've got a chinois filter. It's like just a big old coffee filter. Just like my brine to be really clear. You'll see it's gonna pick up a lot of sediment. And the last one. That's much better. Okay, we've got the brine. I'm back on the stove, bringing it up to a simmer. We're gonna start filling our jars. Now I'll use a sanitized muddler just to pack it in. Pack it in really good. Get in there really good, because when that liquid gets in there, you want to make sure you've got plenty of chilies. Now I have some left over, so what I'm going to do is, you know what, let's have fun. Let's mix the two together. Why not? That'll be something fun. Now if we have leftover brine, guys, cool it down. And save it, put it in the fridge. You can use it again. You don't want to waste. And for these little ones, we're just going to do whole little pepperoncinis. Perfect. You know, it wasn't a large harvest. It was one of our first harvests. And it's typical, you know, to have a smaller one. We have tons of other peppers in the 5-gallon pots. as well. So once the temperatures start to cool down from 99 and 100 to the mid to lower 80s and maybe 69 in the morning, then we'll start to produce more. And of course, rain always does the job. All right, let's get this ready. All right, the brine is nice and boiling. I'm gonna go ahead and pour it in about a quarter of an inch to the top. Perfect. Got lucky on that one. You know, I like just keeping these in the fridge. Sometimes we'll do charcuterie plates when we have friends and family over. I like to put all kinds of pickled vegetables. We call it the pickle plate. Green beans, carrots, chives, all different kinds of peppers. These little ones are my favorite. I will actually do water bath canning for these as well. And in some cases, I'll pasteurize them. And I'll do a video on that. It's basically where you keep it at a certain temperature for like 40 minutes, but you're not boiling it. Kind of keeps everything crisp. Another thing you can do is you can put a bay leaf in each one of these if you do water bath them, and that will also keep them a little more crisp. Let's put the lids on. Wipe that edge, some vinegar. Pull that one out, I don't want anything to mess with the lid. There we go. Just finger tight, not too tight because you'll warp the lid. I like to turn them upside down for a little bit. There we go. Super simple and fun to do. So I'm so excited. First food preserving of the year. A quick pickle, one of the easiest things you could do. Hey, if you've never done it before, super easy. A lot of you homesteaders out there, you know, do this all the time. But this came out really good. I'm gonna set this on the counter on a towel. You don't want it to touch like granite or anything really cold. It could go into shock and you can blow up your can. We're gonna sit here and listen for the pop and we're gonna enjoy it. I hope you liked our little 2 or 3 days together. Hey, it's 99 degrees out today. The clouds are coming in. We do have a chance of rain. I'll definitely be filming that this weekend. Rochelle has a really cool project that we're gonna film this weekend. So I'm excited about that. So you'll see that in the next video. Hey, I'm having a blast with you guys. Thanks for watching. Hey, subscribe. Like, I want to put a special thanks out there to Miss Lippy. Thanks, Miss Lippy and buddy. You did my mama's recipe, and that really means a lot to me. I'll put a link into that. We appreciate you guys. Hey, if you're ever in Texas, you got friends here. Hey guys, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.